Welcome by Retro Machines. My name is Victor Bart, and in this video we're gonna take a look on this compact system from a dumpster. I don't know yet if it's a computer vlog or a teardown Friday, so let's find that out. The system is still working, so it won't be a teardown Friday video, but a normal computer vlog. I don't know much about this compact system. It looks like a terminal, but it's actually just a normal business computer. So let's see what we have here. We have 256 megabytes of memory, probably a 10 gigabyte hard drive and a CD-ROM player. And I think that the BIOS battery is a bit empty. It has an Intel network card. And the hard drive is empty. We all know how an Inkless BIOS looks like, so let's be different this time. Really interesting. And I like this smiley here. So let's go in the first menu, also with that smiley. The system is a compact iPad desktop with a Pentium 3 866 MHz. So it's a Socket 370 chip. Running at 133 MHz with 265 kilobytes of cache, 265 megabytes of memory running at 133 MHz. Really interesting info. More cool info. Oh, I don't know what I did. I couldn't read the BIOS. Really interesting BIOS. Let's see what we have here. Ah, this is the IDE configuration with a 10 gigabytes Seagate hard drive. But wait a minute, here it says 10 gigabytes and here it says that it isn't 20 gigabyte hard drive. So there's something strange there. Okay, let's see why the hard drive is saying 10 gigabytes instead of 20 gigabytes. So now I'm going in the English BIOS. Oh, wait a minute, I'm going into the Dutch BIOS, so most people can't understand that either. Aha, that's better. I don't see an option about a hard drive, why it's only shown 10 gigabytes. But let's go out of the BIOS and take a closer look on the system itself. Let's check out the system. Here we have a power button, hard drive LED, power LED, front audio, two front USB ports. Here we have a sticker designed for Windows 2000 or Windows NT 4. Here we have an Intel Inside Pentium 3 sticker. And here we have a CD-ROM player with a special button under it. And if we press that special button, the drive comes out. So I think this drive is swappable for a floppy drive. Let's check out the back of the system. Here we have a VGA port and 4 USB ports. So in total this system has 6 USB ports, which is a lot for a Pentium 3 system. Here we have onboard network card and an onboard sound card, mouse and keyboard, one COM port, one parallel port, and here we have the power supply. Here we have a Windows 2000 license sticker, and this is my code, so don't steal it. Let's see how I can open this system. Compaq always uses special torque screws, so let's see if I have the right screwdriver for it. Let's see if this one fits, because this one fits here on the power supply screws, but they here are some other size, so let's try. And it doesn't fit. And there's even the little pin in the middle, so I need my toolkit to get this one open. But luckily I have my iFixit kit, but they don't sponsor my channel, so I can't tell you how great this kit is. Let's see which size I need. This one is too big, yes. Maybe this one, it fits there, and yes, I cut them out. Stupid compact screws, I really hate them.
Okay, we take out this plastic piece. Do we need to take something off here, maybe? That sounds more like breaking clips. What a shit machine to open. Oh, I can't say words like that, because otherwise my video will be flagged that it's not advertisement friendly. Okay. Yeah, we have a panel of the system. And here we have the hard drive, and it really says ST320014, so it must be 20 gigabytes. So maybe there's a jumper for a 10 gigabyte setting, and Compaq just sold it as a 10 gigabyte. Here the jumper is on cable select, and there are no other jumpers on the drive. I'm really starting to hate this machine, because it's too hard to open. What's wrong with this system? I can't get the panel off. And I don't want to use brute force right now. Yeah, I cut it off with some extra force. And here we have the memory banks. So let's get them out. This stick is 128 megabyte from Kingston. And we have an Hyundai 128 megabyte stick with a Compaq sticker. So this is the original stick, and this one they placed it later. So two memory banks with SD RAM. Let's remove more parts. So we probably end up with a Teardown Friday video if I can't get the system back together after I take it apart now. Okay, this is one of the most terrible designs of computers I ever seen. And there are screws everywhere on stupid places, and it now falls in. Oh, more screws here. Okay, it's now falling apart. I have a spring here. And we achieved nothing. Yay, more Compaq screws. Screw you, system. Okay, we achieved something because we can see the motherboard. Great! And I probably can't get the system back together after I'm done with removing all these parts, because I don't know where the clips goes and the screws, and it's a terrible system. Okay, here we have the motherboard with the CPU socket and a passive heatsink, but cooled by the power supply. And the power supply is a 75 watt unit. So let's remove the CPU cooler with plastic clips. They always break off. Okay. There it goes. And the CPU is an SL4CB, and that is the Intel Pentium 866 MHz. So it's a pretty fast Pentium 3 chip. Here we have the oversized Compaq PC speaker, and I think it's probably also connected to the sound card. Here we have the BIOS battery, which is probably empty, and there's a little PCB here, so let's see what that is. It's some kind of memory module or something. Oh, it's a Compaq display cache. So this module helps the onboard video card, which uses part of the system memory, to be a little bit faster. So that's a nice little detail. And with the Intel onboard graphics, this isn't really a gaming machine, because you only can play 2D games, and almost all 3D games run very, very slow. Here we have the Intel network chip, and there's not much expansion on this motherboard. A nice detail of this system board is that the front USB ports and audio ports are also directly on the motherboard. So this motherboard is really specific built for this machine, and all the capacitors are the really big ones and are in good shape. So that's the compact quality. Because this system is not really worth keeping, I'm just gonna tear it down further and make it in a teardown on Friday. Because it's not really a gaming system and an office system is really boring, and I can also do retro office work on my fast gaming Pentium 3 rigs. So let's tear it down. Can we please have a moment of silence for this dead spider that dies in this ugly compact system? This is really a terrible death for him. So let's be quiet for a moment. Thanks for the respect for the spider. Nice, I finally took off all the plastic covers. So now let's try to get out the motherboard. Here we have the motherboard out of the system, and the IDE port is on the back. And this port to the CD-ROM player. Oh no, more plastic parts, so let's see if I can take them off. Oh no, the spider web is getting tangled on my screwdriver. Oh no, what should I do with it? Let's find him a new home. So here we have his new home. The heat sink. Ah, that's better for him. Let's give him a nice quiet spot here on the table. The compact PC speakers are really big and they have a nice shape. Okay, I created a big mess on the table. So let's sort out this mess on the table and see what I can keep from this system. Because most parts are proprietary and not usable in anything else than this compact system. So here we have a pile of plastic and metal pieces that are really just crap. You can't do anything with them. Here we have the chassis. Here we have the piece that was between the CD-ROM player and the motherboard. And here on the PCB we have a spaceship. That's nice. I hope you can see it. Let's focus the lens. Look, a nice spaceship. That's a nice detail. Here we have the PC speaker. Always nice to keep. The video card cache module is not compatible with anything else, so it's not worth keeping. Here we have the motherboard, and here on the motherboard I found another spaceship. So let's take a close look on this spaceship. Look how cool it is. It looks like an American SR-71 super fast aircraft. The power supply is a proprietary unit with not many cables, but you can always make a nice lap power supply of it, or take the fan out or do something like that. Here we have the two memory modules, and they are compatible with all machines, so it's really nice to keep. Of course, we're gonna keep the CPU, the heatsink, the spider, and the heatsink clip. And of course, I'm gonna keep the hard drive, and I will test it out before I put it in my collection, so I know it's working. And we're gonna keep the CD-ROM player. Because I don't have much laptop CD-ROM players, so you never know when it comes in handy. But I'm not sure if this is a normal CD-ROM player connector or something proprietary for Compaq. So let me know in the comments. So here you have it, the computer vlog about the Compaq iPad desktop system that turned into a teardown Friday. Thanks for watching. Please like and share this video, subscribe and leave a comment. You can join Retro Machines on Facebook and you can support me on Patreon.
On the tactical map. Otherwise, get the hell out of there. Repeat, we are pulling out and commencing airstrikes. Give us targets or get below.